down, coming in very slowly, and Sawyer closes in on him once again. Brings him back into the ring, and Brown has not been able to put it together. Sawyer catches him with a high knee lift to the side of the head. Sawyer down across his chest.
Hey, why don't we go ahead and pull the man? You ain't got to keep pulling the man up like that.
High vertical suplex by Buzz Sawyer. As Brown again back to the canvas.
Hey, Sawyer, now this ain't right. I got faith.
Sawyer just jumped Tony Atlas, came right over that top rope, and has Atlas catching him repeatedly now, pounding away at it, just charging back. And again, we're trying to get order restored here. Buzz Sawyer trying to punish
Soto. All right, Sawyer setting his sights on Jose Luis Rivera. And look at this, Sawyer fighting now, throwing over the top rope. Look at that. One would almost be inclined to express an opinion that the man is somewhat deranged. Would you not agree, Lord Alfred Hayes?
Well, I keep wondering to myself, where does Lou Bono find these, and why does he persist with them?
Look at the treatment right now. That Bulldog Buzz Sawyer is dishing out to the great star out of Puerto Rico, Jose Luis Rivera. Oh, this man is absolutely awesome. Comments from Captain Lou Albano as he looks on. Most interested, I'm certain, in the career of this man.
This is a crazy man, Gene. This is really a wild man.
Now, there's got to be a question as to the man's mental stability. He is tremendously hyper, and that is certainly visibly obvious.
Well, Gene, you look at Lou Bono. He has those things in his face, in his ears, all over his body. He knows that that does something to somebody else's temperament, another wrestler's temperament. He encourages this in his wrestlers. He has the animal steel. He has him.
But I'll tell you what. Demonstrating this week that he is capable of making a big time, and that he has with his arrival at the World Wrestling Federation. Those fingernails across the back of Rivera. A slam into the canvas, and oh my word, look at that. No way to treat a human being, and certainly not in good sportsmanlike taste. Look at this Buzz Sawyer. Oh, and another slam of Rivera into the canvas. He actually sounds like a dog.
He does.
Hence, Bulldog Buzz Sawyer. Oh, flying elbow that rocks Rivera. Rivera drapes over the ropes. Oh, and another shot from Sawyer. Listen to those animal-like sounds. Oh, and now to the face, actually to the mouth, as Sawyer rips away. This man is unbelievable. Whether the World Wrestling Federation will tolerate his tactics or not, only time will tell. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, come on. That is totally uncalled for. Referee to disqualify Sawyer, and justifiably so.
Something's going to have to be done about this, Gene. I just can't see this type of behavior being accepted in the World Wrestling Federation.
But I don't know if officials will continue to tolerate the ways and means, if you will, of one Bulldog Buzz Sawyer. And certainly what he is doing right now, I think, somewhat typifies all that I've seen. Oh, Rivera comes back with a right, but I don't know if it has any effect on this madman. Oh, Sawyer retaliating with a flying elbow to the side of the head. Oh, that's out. Picked up. Oh, and listen to the screaming of the animal-like sounds of Sawyer with that vertical suplex. Rivera totally out of it. That is a bulldog, ladies and gentlemen. Bulldog Buzz Sawyer. I have not seen anything like him before. Now fighting. Come on, ref. Disqualify the man.
That was a wild, high, crazy backdrop suplex that Bulldog Buzz Sawyer gave to Rivera. He hasn't given Rivera a single chance here.
Well, you know, during the course of this match, Lord Alfred Hayes, Bulldog Buzz Sawyer has openly, blatantly, and flagrantly either bent or broken every rule in the book. Rivera trying to assert himself, but I don't know. Oh, look at that. Look at, oh, power slam. This man is amazing, I must say that. Two, three, it's all over. Oh, come on, get him off. Come on, ref.
This is made up of this man right here, Buzz Sawyer.
Yeah.
That's probably as vicious as any guy in wrestling. Look at him driving the guy's face in the mat, now rubbing it in the mat, along with Muta.
And the Dragon Master.
Whoa.
And I believe that indeed that man in the being in the costume is the Dragon Master.
Uh-oh, look out, look out. Sawyer's pulling that mat back. Now he's going to rub his face in the cement. Oh, gosh. That went off like a shot.
Look, even,
gets up the mat.
Even Gary Hart thinks that Buzz Sawyer went a little bit too far there. Wow. We heard the smack. I'm not quite sure, fans, that Paul Drake is going to be able to get back into the ring by losing you from his stable.
That's a matter of opinion. I can't take a whole lot away from Buzz Sawyer as far as being tough. I've been commentating properly, but that's a matter of personal opinion. Beautiful vertical suplex going for the pin. Let's see if he's got it. He doesn't want it, Crispy.
Just a savage kick to the head there of Paul Drake. And there you see Hart loving every minute of it, I guess you'd say. Just about jackknifes Paul Drake with a solid elbow. Wow. That demonic, possessed laugh there of the mad dog Buzz Sawyer. Paul Drake is backing up. I think he said just about enough here.
Every time he lays a hand on somebody, it just makes me cringe. Oh, I'm glad I'm not in there.
Terry, you have given some chops, and you've taken some.
Oh,
but gee. Well, we wanted to bring you a wrestling match here. It's clear we're not going to be able to do that. Let's see just how long this fella, Paul Drake, is going to be able to withstand the onslaught of the mad dog.
Very proud of himself, very pleased with himself. In fact, it even humors him.
Well, you've got to wonder if this is a signal to you or not, Terry Funk, from JTEX.
I think it's a signal to Ric Flair. I think it's a signal to Sting. And I think it's a signal to the Andersons that, hey, they mean business.
No JTEX doubt about
that. Means business.
No way. This Paul Drake is just about worn out. Just a slap there from Buzz almost knocks him down. Wow, a valiant effort here, but Drake has got to be intimidated by the presence of the other members of JTEX other than the great Buddha. Oh!
The head, this has got to be it.
Drake is just out of it. Look at that, he's almost in convulsions. Well, I think, Terry, you know what's going to happen now. As Gary Hart is so fond of saying, dogs can fly.
Can the dog fly? Can the dog fly? Well, Buzz Sawyer can fly off that top rope, I'll guarantee you. It looks like the gears of Amber sucked the hair right off the top of his head. Two, three.
Here is the winner, mad dog, Buzz Sawyer.
This man, when he joins forces with the Dragon Master and the great Muta to take on Sting and the Andersons, it's going to be quite a confrontation. Hope to remind all you fans, the NWA, this Monday night in the Omni in Atlanta, it's this Monday night, New Year's night, 7:30, Ric Flair to defend the World Heavyweight Championship.
Andersons, They don't want no fight at your
cost. The big six-man reunion. Sting, is he the newest horseman? Hey, if it works, you know, go with it.
Exactly.
He's going to be with the Andersons Monday night in the Omni. Look at Sawyer, that big forearm right to the back of the head of Larry Sanchez.
Well, see, this is the height of an insult to a wrestler rubbing his face on the mat. I watched Sawyer wrestle as a high schooler. He was a state champion in high school, and he had that same vicious, mean streak in him as a high school athlete, and it's only intensified since he's been in the professional ranks.
You know, Gordon, he's got that Peter Boyle look, that rather large, exposed cranium there. I don't know if there's anything in there or not, but he is as physically tough as anybody I've ever seen in a squared circle. And I know, we know how tough Ole and Arn Anderson is. The dog will fly here. Ooh, big splash right off the top.
Extremely dangerous.
Thank you.